Hello everyone, and welcome back to another episode from Iskallia, and we are starting things off at our surprise mechanic shop we have made in the last episode. And judging by the era taking south, we should be out of stock. Yes, we have made a stack of diamonds, which means we have to restock the said shop. And I have done a restock, and if it will fly off the shelf in less than 2 days, I'll have to raise the price. On the next day, I have been tagged in Discord in regards to the horrible noise coming from my shop, and that means I am out of stock again. What can we have instead of the sound effects to say that we run out of stock? I'm not going to spend an entire episode here, just saying. So, first we need to replace a diamond in a filter with a diamond block. Then we go to this hopper line over here and we place two resting pieces like a saw, so that per each diamond block we... So, per each diamond block, customers are going to have 3 trials, which is basically 3 diamonds per box. Now I think of it. I think I have chosen one of the worst types of shops possible, because we have to obtain our goods manually, and as you can probably tell from what I'm doing in this series, my entire playstyle is centered around getting rid of manual resource gathering, so I think I have shot myself in the foot. Now, if we put a diamond block, we should get 3 runs per block. And... one lamp has turned off. And... And... what just happened? Item was just invisible. You know, that might be actually an issue, and maybe I should consider doing something about it. Alright, so... I think it works. So, to show that we have run out of stock, I have installed this little circuit over here. So, if we have no items in the dropper, this comparator will turn off, this redstone torch will turn off as well, it will depower this piston, and... boop! This will happen. We will break the play button, and customers won't be able to spin the wheel. So, we have finished yet another project, and as a result, we have another set of random shulker boxes all over the place, and another bunch at the piston bolt project. So, we need a storage system, and while we have this one, it was created literally at day one, and it doesn't cut the amount of items we have at the stage. Over there, I was preparing for the similar but bigger storage, but... it is just so annoying to find items in sorting systems like this. And you know, I have designed a very unique and cool storage system design you can see in the icons right now, but since then I have found that that design has too many compromises, so... in the background I am designing the ultimate storage, and... it will require tons of iron, and I mean tons of iron, and these guys will help us to solve this issue. So, we need to make a villager breeder and an iron farm, and when it comes to the trading hall... basically, I have spent 2 episodes on this 1.13 trading hall, and I haven't used it at all. And after all, I can get all my gear from the end busting, so... trading hall can wait. Somebody has lost his trident at my shop, and because of the claim, he cannot... break in and take it back, so it is probably somewhere over here. Okay, where can it be? It's not in chest, by the way, 2 diamond blocks. You know, one of the worst things in this life is trying to find something somewhere. Unfortunately, it seems like his trident has probably despawned by now. Meanwhile, somebody wants to visit my base. And I have a suspicion that something might happen, so I should be prepared. And here he is. What a beautiful day to trade with villagers. This weird-looking villager doesn't trade for some reason. Nidwits are white now. Is that a 1.14 change? I wish I had just pause button. So, I showed him my base, my trading hall and stuff like that. But then, this happened. Huh? Ah, I see how it is. I see how it is. Man, I can talk properly while I'm fighting, but it seems like I am this is the dead end. My head looks fancy, he said. This is what you get when you try to kill me. Now I think of it. I'm not sure if you actually tried to kill me, like, for real. Like, there wasn't much of a fight, to be honest. Now we give him his items back. And something extra on top. I suppose I should have asked if you have spare first. Maybe. Or maybe not. Now is the time to make a villager breeder. This design was showcased by Impulse SV, and it is basically a villager breeder and a carrot slash potato farm combined. And in this segment I have decided to move this farm one block up, and I have made a second layer of dirt on top of the first one. This farm is powered by two breeding villagers sitting in the central chamber, and four farmers in the farming cells throwing carrots at those two villagers. Actually, having just one farming cell is technically enough, but why would one build one when you can build four? And in this segment, my villagers rejected to sleep for some reason, and sleeping is necessary because this way villagers will naturally end up in the holding cell made of trapdoors. But only one villager has managed to sleep for some reason, and when other villager joined the sleepage, he was stuck sleeping even during the day, but eventually everything just fixed itself. And now villager breeder is done. Well, we need three more farmers and we need a collection mechanism for carrots and babies down there. But the breeder itself is operational. When I have made our trading hall back in 1.13, instead of just disposing bad villagers into the soup, I've been collecting them here the entire time, knowing that I'm going to need them at some point. And I was totally right. Villagers point finding in 1.14 is the worst. They just wander all over the place, all over my redstone. Oh boy. Why? Why all villagers I have moved so far was really interested in this specific corner for some reason? Maybe if I move him over here. Like this. Okay, now I am determined to make you go to the minecart. We'll be right back. Here you go. And now my turn. And watch him stop halfway there by being unloaded. Oh, hello there, my dude. What do you have? Actually, there is an item I am actually interested in. The leather. And leads. And mob heads. And we have all farmers all in place. Nice. And they are all and they are all farming gears for us. As I said, it's not just a villager farm. It is a carrot farm as well. Then both Paris and Kiaris will go through the tunnel underground and end up in this chest. Well, villagers can't really end up in the chest for the most part, but baby villagers will end up in this room and they will be ready for the future contraptions. I have been in Basin off camera and then I have remembered Alcool Chick to get an achievement. There is an achievement in this game that requires you to move 50 blocks vertically under the levitation effect. And there is a cheesy way to achieve that. So, if we throw an ender pearl downwards while we are under the levitation effect, and boom! We get the said achievement. The thing is, if we go downwards, it will count as well. Next, I wanna build another farm, and as you can probably guess from those sheep in that pen from the site, we are making a sheep farm. In 1.14, dispensers can shear sheep automatically, and if we provide sheep with grass to grow their wool back and run a hopper minecart underneath, we will basically have a fully automatic wool. Well, not fully automatic actually, because we don't supply dispensers with shears automatically, but that is more than enough for us. We have an observer here, and in the moment when the sheep will eat grass, this observer will trigger a redstone dot, it will trigger a dispenser, and it will shear the fresh wool out of the sheep. And then we have a hopper minecart traveling underneath, collecting the said wool. Then said wool will be unloaded at this unloading station and end up in this chest. Yeah. So, this is our automatic sheep farm. Also, I have more than 16 sheep because we need some colors of wool more than others, but we want to have at least one sheep per color. Also, what I wanna do is I wanna have a flint and steel in the dispenser, then we have a campfire on top, and we do this. The idea is that we have a comparator going from one of those dispensers, and when it will run out of shears, and he will assume that all dispensers will go through the shears at the same pace, that will trigger a dispenser and ignite the campfire. And if we would see a smoke, that would mean that we have run out of shears at our wool farm. I have heard a rumor that having entities sitting inside the minecart forces Speaker to not tank entity process of the said entities. But I'm not 100% sure of this one, but I think it's worth testing out. What I am doing here is trying to use armor stuff. Nope, not this way. Here I'm trying to make some sort of an air vent by using end rods and armor stands. It is just tiny bit of centered. It's less than 1 pixel and I cannot nudge it properly. Oh, it's so annoying. Yeah, I think that's enough. Now we're going to copy. Boom. Boom. Paste. No? I'm still considering making a dedicated video about enhancing your client because mods like one that shows you the light levels are just amazing and something people should totally know about. This particular light overlay, for example, is from either Art Figaro or Mini HUD, and with either of them you can press a button to toggle the ability to see the light levels. So, here mobs can spawn now, and now they can't. Also, this yellow border indicates that mobs can spawn here only during the night, and if we will find a dark place, we can see a red border that means mobs can spawn here even during the day. I really hate how light works in this game. Like, we just have to have and hide light sources all over the place simply because otherwise mobs will spawn everywhere. And I just don't like having carpets here. Like, there is no way to truly hide lighting because you can clearly see what you're using to hide the light sources with. And sometimes it's just ugly. Oh boy. Alright, I think we are near the end of the video. In this episode, we have done some work at surprise mechanics and... What is that? Nothing. Then we have Metakara slash villager farm, and as you can see, we have some baby villagers down there. And then we have built this warehouse with the functional sheep farm inside. But this is all I have for you for today. And before we end this video, let's check how much wool do we... Oh, not bad! I wonder how long it will take to run out of shears. We will probably run out of storage space before shears. Well, anyway, this is all I have for you for today. And if you have enjoyed this video, give a like, subscribe if you're new, and save something nice in comments, and press the bell. Bye-bye.